Today on the workshop, I'm going to be building up Tom Daniel, Ghost of the Red Baron. It is a cool character kit, makes a bobblehead. Atlantis Model Company purchased a lot of the old Revell and Tom Daniel and monogram molds, and this is one of the first re-releases they've done. Let's take a look at everything that's in the box. Now, this will be one-third scale, so you're going to see, we're going to go down here a little bit, take a look at all the cool parts in the kit. There's not very many of them. You see the chrome on that? We've got a set of decals for decorating the base of the model kit. We've got a set of yellow lenses for the sunglasses if you choose to use them. The instruction manual on these is also vintage and pretty darn cool. You can see how they got it in color, and then it's got a lot of cool sayings, you know, especially the old vintage, dig man, all that kind of cool stuff on there. So they've gone through and done a really good job on that manual, the vintage look of it and everything. So we'll take a look at the parts. Besides that, we've got a little rubber band in there to give it its bobbleheady nature. We've got the sweet German helmet. That thing is a lot of shiny chrome. We'll clean that up real nice when we're all done. We've got the one-third scale skull, which is really cool looking. Great molding detail on that one. Even the seams on the skull look awesome. We've got his googly eyes and a pin there to hold him in place. And then we've got the base. Now, none of this kit requires glue. You can use it if you want, but it's made to be pressed fit. You can see the rims of the glasses and the earpieces, and then we've got the spike on top of the helmet on that base. So, there isn't really anything to degrease except for the white parts here. Then we're gonna get right into paint. I'll see you soon. At this point, I have the sexy devil out of paint. I did a light mist coat of the ivory over the black. It gives me a lot of cool shadows, a lot of detail. All I need to do for the skull now is press it together. I have to paint his eyeballs red and then just leave little black dots in the center. I'll paint the whole thing red and then just dab a piece of black paint on there. But the eye stems and everything will stay black. The background will stay black. The pinwheel, we'll put those in through the back just like they direct. Then we'll put the rubber band around the back, we'll snap the head together, and then we'll push everything together. So I just want to let you have a look at all the pieces and parts when you do yours. Now, of course, you don't have to paint anything, but I like to go a little bit extra on some of these, and this one I really wanted. What I'll end up doing is making a homemade black wash and washing in his teeth as well, once that ivory paint is dry in the next few hours. Like I showed in the picture, just simple old silly putty pushed in will leave those areas black. We don't have to worry about it then. And silly putty will conform better than any tape or cotton swab or anything that you could ever push in there. The back of the skull, you can see a little bit of the shadows a little better on how I just kind of misted that ivory paint coat over it. The sunglasses, as we saw, were put together. Now, I won't be using those on him, but you can see that they come out very nice and they look wonderful. And then using the old windshield washer Windex trick, the same way they apply decals on real cars, spray it down, and then you can position your decal as long as you want. Then you just take an old sock, you dab off all the extra fluid, let it sit for an hour, it evaporates, and then you made sure that you didn't tear anything or push it over the line or really screw it up. It goes in easy without worrying, because sometimes those can be a pain to line up. All we have to do at this point is paint those eyes, push everything together, and we're all done. We're just going to wash in those teeth, give them a little distinction, and that's it. So this is a really short review. When I come back after doing that wash, after pulling the silly putty out, and after painting the eyeballs, we'll take a look at the Ghost of the Red Baron all assembled. And here we go. A quick look at the Ghost of the Red Baron by Tom Daniel through Atlantis. Re-released for the first time in about, what'd they say, about 50 years. The thing is absolutely fantastic. With just a tiny bit of paintwork, you can bring a little more realism to that skull, especially with the eyes and everything else. But otherwise, it goes together easy. It's fun to put together. The sunglasses can go on and off whenever you want. If you don't glue it together, if the rubber band inside should ever break, you can always replace it. But you got to do it with the rubber band in there, because boy, he bound boing, 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 and he goes left and right, and he's got his eyes going googly in there. So he looks spectacular. He looks like a lot of fun. We could save those sunglasses, put them in, take them out, whatever we want. It's cool to see this kit back on the market. You can pick this up at your favorite hobby retailer, online, or direct through the folks at Atlantis for around a 30 spot, right around there. Shop for it. You'll find it for a great price. Once again, thanks for watching the workshop, watching this quick little review. Don't overlook the SnapTight kits. They can be a lot of fun, especially the vintage winners like this one. We'll see you soon.